Hey everybody, and welcome to this. This is going to be a really, really fun video because I'm going to share with you my freelance journey from its early beginnings, including some work, some crappy work, I have to say, from my really early high school years and my whole freelance journey, stuff that I've never showed before. So this is going to be really exciting. Let's get started. Hey everyone, so welcome to my freelance story. Now, I came to realize that I am sharing on my YouTube channel for almost 4 years, and I've kind of showed how my freelance is growing. And some people might see the last few years and think, oh wow, this is a successful freelance business. Last year I've made over $300,000, you know, doing design job, but it wasn't always that way. And I think the process and the journey has been much longer than what I've been sharing on YouTube for the past 4 years. And I thought it would be really interesting for you guys to show you how this really began, what were my first project, how I got my first clients, and kind of give you a little bit of context so you don't just see the end result and be like, how does that happen? How do I get there? So to give you a little more context, and as I said, I'm going to show you some stuff that I've never showed before. Hopefully it will be insightful and valuable for you. So let's get started. So here is the actual first paid project I ever did back in 2001, which is almost 20 years now, like 18 years. And this project, what I actually did here is the 3D rendering. You actually just see here kind of a pamphlet because I don't have the original renders. And I did this project. This project is for some biblical education project where I was trying to create renders for how the kind of the temple in the desert looked like from the biblical stories. And I did this project when I was in high school. Now I'm trying to think how this project came to me. I guess it was something like kids in my school knew that I'm doing graphics and stuff like that because I would do stuff for my friends, and I would even like put things on the walls at school. So I guess somebody knew and told their dad that I can do some 3D stuff. And so this person approached me and was willing to pay me. So I'm in high school. This is the first time I was doing this as a hobby, you know, playing with graphic. And this is the first time that somebody comes to me and says, I'm willing to pay you to do some 3D work for me. So actually my first work was 3D, not design or web or something like that. And I remember my father kind of helped me out to put some kind of a basic contract, just write it on a piece of paper, like how much money he would pay me and something like that. Actually, horrible things happened with this project. The first one was that about 75% into it, my computer crashed and I didn't back up the project for like, this was a project that I worked on for like 6 months, and I didn't have a backup for like 4 months, and I had to redo the project all over again. Obviously I did not get more money for it, and that's where I learned the super, super valuable lesson of backup. But one more thing happened, unpleasant thing that happened towards the end of the project, was that the guy wanted more and more fixes without paying more money, as sometimes happen with freelance project. I refused, and at some stage he said, all right, fuck it, like let's finish up, give me the original files and I will I'll continue myself. And I said, no, I'm not gonna give you the original files. And he was like, all right, I'm coming to your house to take it right now, or something like that. And I remember I was, again, a teenager, you know, in high school. I was home alone, and this older guy's like, I'm coming to your house to get the files. So I was like, ran away from home just to not be home when he'll be there. Eventually, you know, my father solved it with him, and I don't remember what we end up doing. Did I give him the files or not? But it was, that was like my first freelance experience. Not a good one, but I've proceeded anyway. So here's another project. So basically what happens in Israel, when you finish high school, everybody goes for a military service for about 3 years. And while I kind of had a desk job where I had the opportunity to come back home, so I wasn't like a combat fighter or something like that. And so I got to keep playing and learning graphics even while I was in the army. And I had this opportunity for some ex-military, whatever, something inventor who was working in agriculture. So he invented some machine that would help make agriculture better and raising plants better. And he invented this machine that you can see here on the screen. But this guy was just basically a hands-on inventor. And he brought me on. I'm trying to again think how he came to reach me. I don't really remember how he reached out to me, but basically he knew that I can do 3D graphics and he wanted me to do a visualization of the machines that he actually built. So he actually just built them, but did not have kind of like the sketches for them. So I came there to their plant, factory, I don't even know how to say that, and start measuring kind of with a ruler how big the machine was. And they wanted me to do this with a software that's called SolidWorks, which is basically how industrial designs are planning their, product. And I didn't know anything about SolidWorks, but I went into, Google. This was, again, back in like 2003. So I just like how to learn SolidWorks. I don't remember if I bought like an online course for it, but I quickly learned how to use the software basically. And then I went again to the factory, measured the machine, and then did 3D renders of them. And also these, the kind of sketches that you see on the right, that was part of what I was hired to do, to give them kind of the official sketches of this machine. Now, when I was working for them, basically that's what I was hired to do. But at some point, the guy told me, hey, I'm going to work on a new website. He had some kind of graphic designers that were doing his kind of business card and brochures. And I remember one day he kind of took me to their office. And the first time I kind of saw like a graphic design studio. And I told him, you know what? I think I can do your website. I never did a website before. And I was like, but I think I can learn this. I think I can pull this through. But because we've built this relationship, because I was coming to their factory and I got to know him and he liked me, he kind of trusted me with it. And he said, all right, so do my website. And this is basically the website that I did, designed and actually developed, probably hand coded this website in 2003. Pretty ugly, but yeah, you can see that. That was my work back then. Fast forward 2 years later, probably I'm still in the army at this point. I don't remember. This is another website that I did for a video production company. And this website was actually for a father of a girlfriend that I had back in the time. So this is how I would find clients back in the day. I would just hustle and let everybody know that, I'm doing design, I'm doing website and stuff like that. And everybody that could use some of that, I would do that for them. So this was another paid project that I did. Again, he probably only hired me because, I was dating his daughter or something like that. But yeah, another chance for a project to build my portfolio, which I did use in a portfolio later on. So I started using these projects to build a portfolio that would be valuable to me later on when I try to get a job or more clients. So probably the same year, another kind of a landing page that I hustled for. So this is for a dancing studio. Yep, pretty ugly. So this project was actually for a roommate, like a flatmate of one of my friends. So again, I was really hustling. That's the way I would find clients, just random people that I would know or that my friends knew. So one of my best friends had a roommate, which was a dancer studio. She needed some kind of a website landing page. She told her, hey, my friend can do it for you. I did that. So just hustling project after project. Few years later, and at this point, I already went to design school. And this was the first 2010. This was the first kind of real branding project that I did for a company called Y Party. And again, this is a company of my friends. So the first people who trusted me and gave me the opportunity to do like a real full scale branding project was a company of my friends. And they started the company for wireless headphones where you do kind of silent disco parties, it's called. And they had the original logo that you can see here on the top. And I kind of did a rebrand for them. I created the logo that you see on the button. But for this, I really created a bunch of stuff for them. And I've actually worked with them for multiple months and created tons of stuff for them. So this is an example of some t-shirts I did for them. And this is The website I did for them, you can see on the right, and some flyer I did for them that you can see on the left. And I used to do so many like party invitations and flyers and Facebook posts and all these type of things, which was, first of all, you can see, I think that like my design skills are improving as the years goes by. At this point, I was already in design school and I could start doing things which are more, I would say, feasible. Again, I wasn't paid much for this project. They were my friends. So basically it was half a favor, half a chance for me to create real branding and real project and real website. And this project, because their company was growing rapidly and they got a lot of attention and press, so this was actually a good opportunity to work on a project that has a lot of visibility. At least, you know, here I live in Tel Aviv, Israel, so in here it has a lot of visibility and was a good opportunity for me. So I didn't make tons of money for that because they were my friends, but it was a really good opportunity for me to create a real project and learn how to work, you know, with clients. And working with friends, it's a little bit more delicate to work with friends, but it was really, really a good experience. So I'm fasting forward already to 2014. Now this is that's actually the first time that I stepped from doing freelance on the side to full-time freelancing. I left my full-time job where I was working all along. I was doing freelance project while I was in school, while I was working at full-time jobs. But this here in 2014, that was my first time that I, you know, went on full-time as a freelancer. This is a photo of me and Ori. He's the CEO of a company called Upfront, and I've worked with them. We've worked together for like 3 or 4 years. So he was my first kind of like retainer client as a freelancer, and I did tons of stuff for them. Again, we worked like 3 years together. So I did everything for them, from branding, website, their company, they're a startup company, and they're working, they're doing kind of white labeling apps and services for the food industry. So I got to work on many different brands within the food and beverage industry. It was really interesting and a really, again, first really long-term relationship. Also the first time that I really stepped up my prices and the value that I've been and brought on tons of services, as I said, from branding, web design, and product design. I feel like this is the first step in my, I would say, like high level professional life. This is kind of a major change in my career, I would say. 2 years later, I was already, and this is at this part, this is a client that's called Lucia, where I actually, I did a case study on YouTube on this project. So at 2017, I was already documenting my life here on YouTube. So you can see a full on case study of how I've built this project for them. And those are a client that I've worked with them in 2017, you know, as a freelancer doing their branding and their website. But originally I met the founder of the company like 3-4 years earlier when I was working at a branding agency and not really freelancing. So it's kind of a really long relationship that, you know, that I've built with them, so that I've met them like 3 years earlier, maintained in touch with them. They actually, the client, I think, they used to stay in touch with me by reading my blog, and so they remembered me. And then when they started a new company, they reached out to me. And at that point, I was already a freelancer, which is the point here I'm trying to show you, is that how these long-term relationship, you meet somebody, you never know that they're going to 3 years later going to turn into a client, but that's how things work. Actually, if I come back to this, how I met Ori. So we were connected through, I was working just before I quit my full-time job. So I was working at a full-time position and I had a friend there and his wife knew him. So just again, showing you how the network of friends that you work with and hang out with, they're gonna be the one responsible for connecting you and making introduction to people who are going to turn out to be high value clients down the line. And this is one of my latest project. Again, I've also shared this on YouTube here. I did a big case study on this, Protantex. And this is Another high level client that I did branding and website for at this stage, you know, I'm charging a lot of money and I'm providing a lot of strategic services for them. And if I'm trying to think about how this project, how we got introduced. So the way that we got introduced was that, actually I have a friend from design school. So I went to design school, like now it's about probably 6, 7, 8 years ago. And, you know, we became friends. She got married to some guy who ended up being an investor, startup investor. Now, because we are friends and she likes and trusts me and recommended me, when he was looking for designers for a few of his startups, she told him, hey, you should hook them up with Ran. So again, just showing you how this network of people that you know and you make friends with over a lot of time are the ones that actually ends up bringing in the clients. And so this, her husband is now an investor and he connected multiple clients to me. And so we had a good relationship of trust now because he knows I can help the startups in his portfolio companies. So I think that was a really, really fast forwarding career that is now 18 years in the process, just to show you how these things take time to build, the relationship that leads to better clients and higher level clients are a relationship that you just build with, you don't know who's going to lead you to, you know, to a great project or relationship that will turn into a client relationship. But if you build your skills and you build your reputation and you build your trust over the years, it's easy. It's not easy, but you will, step by step, you will grow and increase your, you know, how much you charge, again, your reputation and your brand with clients. So as I've said in the beginning, you've only seen the end, like 4 years might sound like a lot of time, but it's just the end. And because the trajectory is from nothing, 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 and then you start doubling. If you look at the last 4 years, it looks like crazy, you know, like I'm doubling my income every year, but that's just the end of the, what's called the hockey stick, right? There's a lot of time where it's nothing and then bam, it looks like it's, you know, it's raising up very quickly, but it's, you know, what was it? There's a sentence like an overnight success, 10 years in the making or something like that. It's a long process, guys, to succeed as a freelancer. But if you put in the time, if you build those relationships, it's possible and it's amazing. And I hope that you're going to get there soon enough. Let me know in the comments where you are right now in your freelance journey. I want to hear from you and I'll see you on the next video.